Hello students, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to do chapter 12, that is Heron's formula, class 9, exercise 12.2. In the previous session I have done exercise 12.1. Now exercise 12.2 is the first question. I have written the question over here so that if you don't have the book then you can get the question over here. Or those who don't have the book, please download the PDF of NCERT books. A park in the shape of a quadrilateral ABCD has angle C equals to 90 degree, AB equals to 9 meter, BC 12 meter, CD 5 meter and AD 8 meter. So how much area does it occupy? That means you will find out the whole quadrilateral's area. Now the quadrilateral will be looking like this, where C is 90 degree, BC is 12 meter. You can see the figure. I have drawn the figure according to the question and I have joined this BD diagonal over. Why BD diagonal? Because if we are joining BD diagonal then we are easily getting this part as right triangle, and we all know that right triangle's area is very easy to find. So for that reason I have made this right triangle and this one. So for this triangle it is very easy to find out its area, but for this triangle we need to find out this BD. Now BD, how can we find it out? BD we can find out just by Pythagoras law from this triangle. Okay, so BD we can find out by Pythagoras law. I'm just writing it once so that number one you have to find out area of triangle BCD, then number two you have to find out BD by Pythagoras law, number three you will find out area of triangle ABD by Heron's formula. Number four, you have to add both areas and that will be the answer. Now those who have forgot, I'm just repeating it once. Area of a triangle, if all three sides are known and the Heron's formula is S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C square units, where S is the semi-perimeter, A, B and C are three sides of the triangle. So if you can find out this, then it is very easy. Suppose this is number one and number two, that means you have to find out number 1 plus number 2's area. Understood? So this is clear, students? Okay. Moving on to the next question, number 2. Question number 2 is quite same type. That's why I have given it as homework. And along with question number 2, I have mentioned exercise 12.2. That means this exercise 6, 7, 8, 9 also will be your homework. Rather, these all are also homework. The questions I am doing over here also will be your homework, but will be done in classwork copy, to be completed in classwork copy. But these five questions to be completed in homework copy. Now question number 3. Question number 3's figure is like this. I have not written the question number 3, just the figure I have drawn. So, and you want to find out the whole figure's area. Now the first part here, this is like an aeroplane. So the first part, this is the number one portion, it's an isosceles triangle. So this side 5 cm means this side also 5 cm. Here 1 cm means here also 1 cm. Rest all things I have just drawn on the figure. So what do we have to do? Number one's area. Sides are 5 cm, 5 cm, 1 cm. So you can find its area, find it by Heron's formula or isosceles triangle's area formula. Okay, you can use both things. Isosceles triangle's area formula, if you have forgot, just open your class 7 old book. We have done it in class 7. Coming to the second part's area. Second part is a rectangle, you can see. Second part's area will be rectangular area, where rectangle's length is 6.5 cm and the breadth is 1 cm. Right. Coming to number 3 area. Number 3's area is trapezium's area, which you all have done in class 8. The same type of question you have done. So I haven't done here. So 1 cm, this side 1 cm, this side 1 and 2 cm. You need to find it out by class 8's trapezium's area formula. Then coming to number 4 and number 5, which are the wings. So these wings, both wings will be of equal areas. That means these are right triangles. So right triangles area formula we will be using. So these are very easy. Now once we have got all 5 parts area, we will just add all areas together and we will be getting total area, and that is the answer. Moving on to the next question, question number 4. Question number 4 also I have written over here. A triangle and a parallelogram has same base and the same area. If the sides of the triangle are 26 cm, 28 cm and 30 cm and the parallelogram stands on the base 28 cm, find the height of the parallelogram. Now, the figure will be like this. I have drawn the triangle as ABC, this one, and the parallelogram like this, which is ABEF, right? Now, triangles, all three sides we know from question. So the first thing we have to do, that is find the area of triangle ABC by Heron's formula. Heron's formula I just wrote in the for the first question. So that formula you have to use. I'm just saying it as A. Suppose the result, whatever you are getting here, M. Okay, I have given it as M. Now this M, because it is written that triangle and parallelogram has same area, that means this M, which is area of the triangle, will be parallelogram's area. One thing, that this is the short form of writing parallelogram. One pair of parallel lines and GM. So parallelogram's area. Now parallelogram's area formula is base into height. So this M means the area of the triangle is equals to 28 cm, which is the base of the parallelogram, and height of the parallelogram. So height of the parallelogram will be M divided by 28 cm, and that's the answer. Coming to question number 5. A rhombus shaped field has green grass for 18 cows to graze. If each side of the rhombus is 30 meter and its longer diagonal is 48 meter, how much area of grass field will each cow be getting? That means we have to find out the total rhombus area and then we have to divide it by 18. So the rhombus figure will be like this. Okay. Now, step number 1, that is AB. AB will be half of the diagonal. This is the longer diagonal, 48 meter. So AB will be 24 meter. Now BC, ABC, I have given this smaller triangle's name as ABC. You can see B will be the 90 degree angle. So ABC will be right triangle. So we can apply Pythagoras theorem. Now BC will be this one by Pythagoras theorem. Root over of hypotenuse square minus perpendicular square. And that is giving us 18 meters as BC's value, right? So BC is 18 meter. Now we have got the base and the perpendicular, or the height we can say. So we can find out area of triangle ABC very easily, half into base into height. and the answer will be 216 meters square. The area of this triangle is 216 meters square. Now, area of the whole rhombus will be 4 into 216 meters square. Now, this is the whole area. So, each cow will get 4 into 216 divided by 18 meters square. And then by cancellation, we are getting it as 48 meters square. And this is the answer. So, all these four questions that I have discussed here today, you have to just complete all the questions, calculations in your classwork copy. And these questions to be done in homework copy. So, this is all about today's session. I hope everybody has got the clear idea about this portion and this topic. So, topic's name actually was Area of Quadrilateral by Hero's Formula. Or you can say it's application of Hero's Formula. So, that's all for today. Thank you, everybody.